I am Marian Isguera from 3CRIA2-4 of PINMA Arroyo University from College of Criminal Justice Education. The objectives I should meet are define the bloodstain pattern analysis and explain the importance of bloodstain pattern analysis. This is all about blood analysis. It includes the bloodstain pattern analysis, types of bloodstains, documentation of bloodstain evidence, sampling bloodstain for DNA profiling, importance of bloodstain pattern analysis and reconstruction of crime scene, and tools to determine area of convergence and area of origin of blood spatter. So first, what is bloodstain pattern analysis? It is the interpretation of bloodstain at a crime scene in order to recreate the actions that caused the bloodshed. So yung mga analysts, yung mga nag-examine sa size, shape, distribution, and location ng bloodstains para makapag-form ng opinion about what did or did not happen in crime scene. So ano nga ba yung mga types ng bloodstains? First is the passive stains. It is the results from an action other than a directed force to a blood mass. Ito yung mga round drops na mga blood stains. Next is the transfer stains. It is the result from objects coming into contact with existing blood stains. For examples is the shoe print and wipes of blood in the floor or in the wall. And last is the impact stains. This is the result from a blood projecting through the air and are usually seen as spatter. So, ito daw yung mga usually na nakikita mo na mga blood spatter. For example is, when yung baseball bat is na-contact niya yung blood, and through the impact nung baseball bat is, nag-i-splash yung blood na yun yung nagiging spatter. Next is, how to document the bloodstain evidence. First is, photograph the bloodstain, then, know the direction of bloodstain, and find the angle of bloodstain using ruler. Next is the sampling bloodstains for DNA profiling. So we have two. First is the pattern analysis. Pattern analysis, look for the physical characteristics of the stain patterns. Dito sa pattern analysis is idedetermine niya yung size, shape, distribution, or yung location and texture when the stains found. Next is in the reconstruction. It is made to determine the sequence of events about what occurred during and after crime. Usually na ginagamit sa reconstruction is yung forensic mannequin. Dito sa reconstruction, masasagot yung mga tanong na where is the person bleeding from? Did the stain came from other person or what type of crime has occurred? Next is what is the importance of bloodstain pattern analysis and reconstruction of crime scenes? So the important functions of bloodstain pattern analysis is to support or corroborate witness statements and laboratory and postmortem findings. So dito naman yung bloodstain pattern analysis is isusuport niya or papatunayan niya na totoo yung sinasabi ng witness and yung findings sa postmortem. And the last one is the reconstruction of crime scene. It is the discovery consists of seeing what everybody has seen and thinking what nobody has thought. It provides another evidence and it helps in case study. So dito sa reconstruction of crime scene, pwede ka ulit makakita dito ng mga possible evidence and ito yung makakatulong sa case study na ginagawa ng isang tao or isang investigator. So, what are the tools used to determine area of convergence and area of origin of blood spatters? First is the elastic strings and protractor. It is used to determine the angle and size of blood stains. Next is the mathematical equation, which is the tangent trigonometric function. It is to calculate the angle. And next is the hemospat, to know the size and shape of bloodstains through computer. And last is the limiting angles method, which is examine the physical evidence excluding angles from analysis. That is all about blood analysis. Again, I am Marian Isguera, a criminology student from 3CRIA2-4, and the objectives I met are define bloodstain pattern analysis and explain the importance of bloodstain pattern analysis. Thank you.